Before you hit the water, though, you feel like you hit a solid ground. And it doesn't hurt or anything.
Normally, it does hurt if I hit solid ground.
Generally. And have you ever picked up two cats and you had to put them in one hand?
No, because you can't do that.
Have oh, I've
you,
done it. Have,
no.
They don't like it.
No. My cats don't even like being held at the same time. Mind
well,
you,
regardless,
cats,
you and Lifesaver being held by one hand
oh,
and...
fuck this guy. I hate this guy so much.
Go play nice.
He's the worst.
And he's holding out his other hand and basically created like a wind platform.
I figured he did.
Four.
I hate him.
That's four now. You owe me a lot.
I owe you nothing.
Damn! Good catch.
I owe nothing.
I'm really heavy.
Oh, honey, you weigh nothing. Also, should I be kicking his ass? Is he still evil? I can't tell. Is this one evil? Are you evil?
What? I'm not evil.
He's not glowing green. He's fine.
Glowing green? Wait, I thought your elemental friend was glowing green. Wait, what happened to her? I was in a cage and then I
Oh, honey, we don't know where Feo is. Also, I'm just gonna get you out of here real quick. Things are falling.
Ah, well, sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, I know. You single, by the way?
Why, yes! I'm horribly deformed.
No!
I can make it work.
Did anybody else just picture what I pictured?
I'm not going there.
Okay.
It's don't.
All right.
I'm in my happy place where I don't have to. Okay.
If I might interject a brief interlude.
Go for it.
While she's unconscious, she's kind of swirling in and out of this weird place of energy where she can kind of see herself doing things with her powers that she's never done before.
Ooh.
For all you comic book fans out there, imagine it is kind of like how the negative zone is typically illustrated in Marvel Comics, except maybe a little less threatening. So for my advancement, I have now unlocked the full burn suite.
What?
So
nice.
I can do a couple of new things.
Yay, love it.
And then she wakes up with a gasp.
You wake up and you are in the strip. Now, what used to be like center strip is now kind of flood, like beachfront.
Mm-hmm.
The flooding got pretty bad. For those of you at home looking at your map, basically imagine everything up to Bayview and the hospital is flooded and the J train shut down.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Shit got bad.
Water is so destructive.
But yes, it is.
Is everybody okay?
Yeah, well, no one's ever made a gun out of water, have they?
Shut your mouth.
Saying.
Back to the game, children. So you wake up with a start.
Thank you.
You're basically in one of those makeshift emergency tents.
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys there?
Yeah, right?
I'm asking if you are.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh.
It's been like an hour or two since you made landfall.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You were out for a while.
Yeah.
So Kiss Artist wakes up with a start.
Kate. Is Kate okay?
She's fine. We haven't talked to her, but like nobody haven't heard otherwise.
Ow.
You okay?
Ah! Atlas! Is Atlas okay?
Atlas is fine.
I've got the worst headache of my life right now. What the fuck happened? What the fuck happened to you?
I don't know.
You know those sticky things that monitor hearts and everything?
Uh-huh.
You're on like, you have a couple of those on you.
A whole bunch.
A whole bunch. They had to use a lot.
And I'm the only one I'm like sitting there reading like an Us Weekly, like waiting for them both
magazine.
To like come to.
Highlights for kids.
With Atlas just chilling in my lap, just waiting.
As soon as he wakes up, Atlas jumps out of your lap and...
Yeah.
Yay!
Because Breeze left a long time ago. I was so glad about
Breeze
that.
Breeze has to go be a superhero and do
fucking
stuff.
Fucking worst.
You know what? He has nothing but nice things to say about you.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know he does.
Oh, shit!
No, he's the worst.
He seems great.
Why are you always against me? Why are you like this?
I just think Breeze sounds great.
What?
Mom and Dad are fighting again.
Why are you like this?
Um,
hey guys. I'm trying to think of a non-clumsy way to make this work, but fuck it. I'm really glad everybody's safe, and I just care about you all so much, and I have to know, is there fear in your eyes when you look at me?
You do not ask that. Okay, as a writer, if someone put that on my desk, I would take the red Sharpie and go, no.
Okay.
I will let you ask them out of character when they look.
If you had to pick one, would you say I'm losing or gaining humanity?
No, you know, in that kind of, yeah, concussioned way, she's basically, you know, saying, I know, I just feel like I'm too dangerous. You guys, you know, you just put up with me and I keep exploding and I just don't know what to do. So what I'm trying to do is get a yes or no about whether or not there's fear in your eyes.
Do you guys look at Kid Stardust with fear? Now, currently she's crying, which is probably a first.
Concussion.
Stardust, I'll be real. I'm not sure what happened.
So did we win? That's a no from you.
Maybe. What was the question exactly?
Do you look at her with fear?
No, because I don't know what's going on.
All right.
Okay.
So there's one potential. Maybe.
Charlie is in the process of getting you some aspirin, like out of like next to the table, and a glass of water. And he's just, no, baby girl, now have this. So
there's a potential for me.
Take your potential.
Right. And it also says take plus one forward and mark potential.
Oh, what does awesome. That mean? Plus one forward means at any time you make a roll, you can use that plus one.
Oh, great.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Wait.
So you have a moment of, okay, I'm still human.
Look, someone needs to tell me what happened, okay? Because we were climbing this building, I think you were holding it up, and then suddenly I'm landing and in a hospital, and it's all just a blur.
Okay,
you don't remember? Oh.
I was fighting Gregor.
Okay.
I think.
Swole.
Why would Gregor be there?
Swole.
Teddy.
And I like I'm imagining their beds are right next to each other. I just like lean over to him. I'm just like, look, what happened there was you flew off the tower with Feo, managed to fling you back.
Okay.
But when you came, do you want some?
I'm good.
Okay. we flung you back on the tower, and when we flung you back, you were glowing green like she was. Like everybody that's been under Devro's control.
God, the Green Inferno again.
I think technically it's being rebranded as the Emerald Inferno.
I think green is simpler. Green
it really
has...
is. No. Look, but Emerald Inferno.
Inferno's already a big word.
Guys, yeah. Y'all, we don't have time for semantics.
Look, this is entirely beside the point. I mean, you're right. That's entirely beside the point.
Ding.
But, God. I can't be losing control of my mind, too, okay? Gregor already controls my goddamn body some of the time, and
ding.
If they can...
That's a cell phone going
right.
off.
Right, no, sorry, it took me a second.
What? I'm not who I was born as anymore! I can't control my body half the time, and now I can't control my goddamn head! Jesus Christ! I don't know what I'm supposed to be!
You are having a moment. That's what you are.
Well, yes.
Kid Stardust starts crying, and she runs over and gives you a huge, well, as huge a hug as she can. So, you know, it's kind of like this.
Roll to comfort and support.
Oh, well, I'm going to do that.
That's a move you have.
Okay.
So, as I was saying, for the Doctor Who RPG that we've been playing, the TARDIS is 6, and the Dalek is 1, and we keep rolling this exact combination all the goddamn time. So that's 6 right there, but my mundane is 7. -1, so it's a 5.
Oh. Okay.
Because she's concussed.
Mark
she's
potential.
Okay. Well, as you come up to me then, because it's failed, right?
It's a failure.
As you fail, I go, get away from me! You don't know what I could do! I'm a fucking bomb!
You shove her, and she lands back on the bed.
And I'm just like, shh. And I'm trying to comfort and support, too.
I will let you roll that, but you're at a -1 because Kisaris has failed.
It's like, okay. Wait, I'm dangerous! I'm a freaking monster! Do you guys realize this?
So that is 9.
That's okay. Mundane.
Yeah, so, because it's, so, oh, wait, so it's 9, and then, because I have +2, so it's 11, and then -1, so I have a 10.
Perfect, great. Okay. Go ahead and read from the list and,
So comfort and support, on a hit, they hear you, they mark potential, clear a condition, or shift labels if they open up to you. On a 10+, you can also add a team to the pool or clear a condition yourself.
All right, so what would you like to do?
What were the options again? Sorry.
They mark potential, clear a condition, or shift labels if they open up to you.
Or curly fries.
Mm, that sounds delicious.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to clear a condition because I have a lot of conditions.
Yes, right, that's right. I've got two.
I'm going to clear.
Oh shit! And I was at a minus angry. Two for Pierce the Mask, or for Comfort and Support.
But I'm going to clear anger for that. But I would also like to point out that that was me role playing the sharing a vulnerability or a weakness and ask them if they think I'm losing or gaining humanity. So
I'm going to go ahead and say, because both of them tried to comfort you, the answer is they still think you're a human.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Mm-hmm. So in that case, I get to clear a condition and shift mundane up and any other label down.
Yeah. Okay, great.
So can I clear a second condition?
I will let you do that.
All right,
because you've met things. Also, Jack, you get to add one. You either get to add a team to the pool, or is it clear condition or mark potential?
Clear condition.
Okay, so which would you like?
I am going to... I'm gonna clear a condition.
All right, cool.
But so after I, you know, I just and I like kind of get him to lay back down on the bed. I just like very gently like I have my hands on his arm as much as I hate doing this right now because he's so grotesque.
I'm a big grossy.
And I'm just, Swole, you were amazing. Like you dove after Feo and you. You know, you did what you needed to do, and it's not your fault with Devereaux taking control. It's not your fault at all.
I can tell you this, and I should have just told you all this from the beginning. I don't think Devereaux is in control of the Green Inferno. I think it's a loose power that's out there and doing its own thing, because Devereaux has asked me to try and find the green power and bring it back to the Green Inferno and bring it back to him. And I think that if he was in control, he wouldn't need us to do that.
Charlie, did he just say that Devereaux asked him to get the Green Inferno and that he thinks Devereaux should control it?
I'm not saying Devereaux should control it, but if... Even if he's a bad guy, and trust me, no one thinks he's a bad guy more than I do. It's clearly a problem having it out there under control, and someone's gotta take it under control. And he can fix me, okay? I know he can. And so if it's just one bad thing, then I can get to go back to a normal person. You know, maybe it's not that bad to work with him just once. Actually, that makes me realize, I pull up my phone and check the
You text. Have a bunch of text messages from him.
No, and then, so I actually reach over and take the phone out of his hand.
Oh.
Yeah. You've been texting him this whole time and you didn't tell us?
Well, he's been texting me. It's but been you've very been text- frustrating.
But you've been talking to him.
I've been in contact with
Why
him.
Why didn't you tell us?
Well, it wasn't anything we weren't going to do anyway. Like, trying to stop this horrible mind-controlling entity, that makes sense for a superhero team. And it was my own personal decision, okay? He's going to fix me physically, and that's my decision to make.
So you were putting the team at risk by not sharing all of your information with us.
Oh, we put ourselves at risk by fighting supervillains all the time. That's how the job works.
But you weren't completely open with us, and that's the part that bothers
me. You kind of remember what he was talking about last week when you were mad at Kevin about putting the team first and all that stuff.
So you're going to be a hypocrite right now.
I would be a greater asset to the team if I wasn't this freakish hunk of meat all the time. If I could get through doors like a normal person, it would be more useful for the team. Remember when I was a normal person for like an hour the other day?
Yeah,
you were That could be me
awful.
All the time.
No, you were awful when you were a normal person.
Oh, okay. Well, you don't have to be me when I'm not a normal
person.
Both
of you shut the fuck up.
That lands.
This doesn't make me happy. And I don't like working for Devereaux. I don't like having my strings pulled. Swol has a couple of good points in this argument. I think he's misguided. But I can't fault your desire to want to feel like a normal human being again. All right. Let's play ball. But we're going to make Devereaux tell us exactly what he knows. And we're going to play it for everything that it's worth.
Thank you, Starbust. I appreciate it.
And then we're going to punch him in the dick.
I'm not going to fight you on that one either.
I want, I'm adding a team to the pool, and I want all of you to mark potential for that, because I love that.
Yay!
Charlie, I'm sorry. I don't like it either, okay? I don't. But if it's a means to an end, and we can get a little bit ahead of Devereaux, I think it's gonna help us in the end.
Look, if there was any information that I thought made it significantly more dangerous for you guys not to know, I would have told you. We were gonna go after the Green Inferno. That was already something we knew was dangerous. It's been destroying our city and killing our heroes.
I'm not arguing that with you, Teddy.
I know, I just want you to know that I wouldn't have done anything that I seriously thought was gonna put you all in danger for the team.
I trust you. There's some trust you're gonna need to gain back, but I trust you.
Okay. Oh, I know. All right, cool. Jordan, forfeit all your influence.
Okay.
Actually, you get to keep it over Kevin.
All right.
So wait, do we?
No, no, you guys still have influence over him. He doesn't have influence over you anymore.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Okay.
That seems fair.
After a moment like that, yeah. You get to keep Chaos Lots, though, because he's one part idiot, one part not here.
Yeah.
Jaeger.
Jaeger.
Charlie, what's going on with the other elementals? Can they help get the water back to where it needs to be?
It'll take a lot. We gotta call the water elementals and the earth elementals and rebuild the beach. And I mean, it'll take a bit, but...
But everyone's safe, right?
I mean, that's what they're reporting. They were able to evacuate the hospital in time, or at least move everybody to, you know, higher floors. You know, they have multiple generators. I mean, Bayview's kind of trashed.
It was kind of trashed to begin with.
Accurate.
The guy who owns the yogurt land is so pissed.
But it's insured, like, so well, he's gonna be fine.
We've like fucked this yogurt land up like a couple times.
At this point, I've been like,
safety pins.
Your new arch nemesis, the yogurt. The yogurt.
The yogurt. Yes.
Though I am going to, I want to keep his phone though.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I need it.
No,
it's my special phone.
It is a special phone.
Does he know where you're at all times?
Yeah, he knows where all of us are at all
Ding.
Times.
So I am going to...
You all know that.
I'm going to wipe the phone of, like, its ability to be traced.
Oh.
You bricked it.
Yeah, I'm going to brick your fucking phone.
That's a special... He can still trace us. We all know that he can trace our whatchamacallem systems.
Comm systems?
Yeah.
I'm still bricking your phone.
I need
have it back.
That is so petty.
That's a specialty phone.
I'm mad. So.
Buckshot hands you back your phone. It go.
I'll fix it later, but I'm mad right now.
And your phone is just he took the phone out of your iPhone.
You can still play solitaire.
My phone was like the size of a
An iPad mini?
Yeah, it's probably about the size of an iPad mini, and it has big physical buttons, yeah. Like a jitterbug phone.
Mm-hmm. Right, we've talked about that before.
Yeah.
Jitterbug phone is the old people's phone that they advertise in the back of Parade magazine, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's the second time Parade magazine's come out today.
Yeah. No, you can have your phone back when I trust you
Alice?
Again.
Well...
Oh, I didn't realize you were my parents now.
Before you say something you regret, Atlas just kind of hops in and gives your face a lick. Because,
you know,
at least someone still likes you.
Can we have the puppetry on that, please?
Please.
Oh, Atlas! You're my favorite too, buddy!
All right. So we're gonna go to the following day. Mm-hmm. So, Buckshot.
Yeah.
Charlie.
Yeah.
School still doesn't get canceled. Despite a flood and most people you know, being evacuated.
I'm actually really happy to go back to something normal.
It is a nice feeling.
Yeah. I get to see my brother, who I have barely seen lately.
Well, you actually haven't seen him until right now. It's towards the end of the day. How many periods? Seven periods?
Six.
Nine.
Wow, nine periods.
Sorry, eight periods. We had eight periods in my high school.
Really? We had six in homeroom.
We had four.
No, six.
We had eight because if we were at school 5 minutes longer, it would have been illegal.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh.
Because my high school was fun.
No, wait. Six periods, four before lunch, two after. Yeesh.
Oh.
I don't remember.
Okay. Jordan, Matt 510, both of those will come into play in a moment. I love you always assume it's the fucking worst.
It often is. Because I don't trust that guy, that's
you
why.
You should trust the chat.
I trust no one,
they are lovely
no
garbage
one,
people.
You know I trust
they
no one.
They are lovely garbage people.
Beautiful garbage.
am I still afraid and angry, VT?
I will let you clear. Everyone gets to clear two conditions. You got home. Kate's not dead. Her family's not dead. Your apartment in South Hollywood is fine.
North South.
All I had left.
North
is,
South Hollywood.
All right I had left border. Was insecure, so I'm good.
We actually never determined where my family lives.
We have not, so we'll go ahead and do that right now.
Because I've been thinking about this every session. I'm like, where does Charlie live? Okay, so because I love pink. And in honor of the Women's March today.
Yes.
Why do women have to be pink, right?
Why so heteronormative?
Why do you hate women so much?
I'm not the one who's saying it's gotta be pink because it's women.
Because that's what
I will separate you two. Uh-huh.
You should, because I'll kill him. So I'm assuming that there's other high schools in the area because it seems like a very large and populated area.
Yes, it is.
So there's districts. I'm going to say that, Charlie's family lives pretty close to the school.
All right.
But in the 8th district, which has not been named yet.
Let's go ahead and the chat do that. Mm-hmm. Okay, chat, go ahead and name District 7 and District 8.
Number 9.
Number nine.
So
we're all a bunch of fucking nerds.
So Charlie's house, record. You can't see it on the chat, but it's like right below this, like the downward, like the panhandle part of District 7 and District 8.
Which I feel like it's called the panhandle.
Probably is.
Yeah.
That probably area is definitely called the panhandle.
Maybe we caught.
All right. Are you gonna
No.
dance out of here going, I don't give a fuck. What was that?
It's a mark drop.
Yeah. It's a pink marker. It's a pink marker.
Hot pink.
Mm-hmm.
Your house was fine. Pink. So during the flooding, your house was fine. Everything was fine.
Yeah. Because we're far enough from the coast that it's...
Right.
But we live close enough to the coast.
It's around fifth period. You said 6 periods a day?
8 periods.
All right. It's around 7th period.
Okay.
It's that weird middle... 7th period just ended. You're about to start 8th period.
Okay.
End of the day. You hadn't seen James since you're too young to drive. You guys got off the bus.
I drive?
No. Oh, right. You can.
Yeah. I'm 16.
Like, I thought you were 15.
No.
What's our vehicle called? I forget.
The firearm.
Right. You guys named the vehicle.
Yes, I forgot.
The vehicle. Just so we're
clear. One of these days, I'm going to make you take Kirby Craft just for that.
pass.
You hadn't seen him since that morning. And you're getting your stuff out of the locker, and he slams your locker shut, and he looks mad. What'd you sign me up for?
I didn't sign you up for anything.
Oh, don't. You know, Chuck, I let you get away with a lot of shit. I let you give me the constant lecture on the elemental thing. I let you get away with a lot. He takes out his cell phone. Do not sign me up for, like, elemental con freak out resistance, all right?
I didn't sign you up for that.
Oh my god,
they
totally
know.
Fucking...
They know.
Know what?
They know that you are. Oh my... You just need to accept it.
Oh my god.
I didn't
you know what?
Sign
I was
you
so much
nicer
to you when you told me you were gay. All right, I want that on record. I was super supportive.
I don't want to hear about it. Okay, the city is falling apart. There's issues going around. If you would just accept your legacy and accept that you're an earth elemental,
I am not an elemental.
You are an elemental. And because Charlie can sometimes be a petty bitch, just stands at his locker.
Sometimes be a petty bitch.
He's a total petty bitch. Just goes, James Malinowski is an earth elemental.
I am going to end you!
Which honestly, people don't really take notice because Charlie does this
people
a
like, that's a strange thing to yell.
Charlie does this shit. Elemental. Charlie does this shit a lot.
I don't know. He's like a drama kid. Ignore him.
Yeah. I think he means faggot.
Oh, wow.
Sorry. I'm sorry. I got that hurled at me more than a few times.
I love that Stephen blanches and I'm just still just like, whatever.
Cheerfully withdrawn.
I don't give a shit.
I don't give a shit. It's like, I don't give a shit. I am one.
I am. I was about a t-shirt.
Just like, I'll call myself a tranny, but if somebody else calls me that, I'm like, nip.
That's our word.
Yeah, it's my word.
So you scream that he pretty much tackles you and puts a hand over your mouth.
Oh my God. Calm down.
This is something you guys have done since you were like,
I know. So I lick his hand because that's how you
that
get
is so gross. That is so gross.
Well played.
I'm 16. I'm not stupid.
Name the biggest bully at your school.
Who's gonna name this school?
I would never be the biggest bully.
Well, well by practicality.
Yeah, technically, you are the largest.
Okay. In a simple.
It's like a difference between the largest state geographically
anymore,
and the largest state population wise.
Flawseed?
I'm still going.
Okay.
Okay.
Also, can you put back the Matt 510 thing just so I have that thing? Thanks.
So, I would probably say the biggest bully. Their name is Deirdre Hollenstock.
Deirdre Hollenstock.
Mm-hmm. It's a girl.
Oh,
yeah.
I like it.
I like it.
Yeah. Yeah.
As you're kind of fighting with your brother, which isn't out of the ordinary for you two, you realize you're standing in someone's shadow, and then a flash goes off. It's Deirdre. And you know, Chucky, this is why you have no friends. Because you're having sex with your brother. Like, I want you to know this because I'm your friend and I'm nice.
Why is everybody calling me Chucky all of a sudden?
The only people who call... your brother calls
Jack
you Chuck.
Asks that.
Okay. Your brother calls you Chuck.
No, he doesn't.
When he's annoyed with you.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah, he does.
No, he doesn't.
I play him.
God,
when he's annoyed at you, yeah, he does. Yeah.
When he's annoyed with you, you're Chuck. When
I'm annoyed with him, he's Jamie, and he hates it, too.
Oh, he despises it. You're twins. You know this shit.
We're terrible.
And she calls you Chucky because she thinks you're, like, a little nerdy pissant, and it reminds her of the cartoon she watched once when she was, like, four.
Because Charlie isn't
Rugrats?
An adorable enough name.
Yeah, I don't remember. They're like,
oh,
young.
My God.
They don't know what Rugrats are, man.
Okay, that's fine.
But yes, it's Rugrats.
Do kids these days not know what Rugrats are?
Dude, Rugrats hasn't been on the air in like 17 years.
That doesn't mean anything. What about Rugrats All Grown Up?
That lasted a season.
It was like a season.
Actually, it was three terrible. Seasons.
What?
Yeah.
Wow. And Pete can't get renewed. Chucky, this is why you have no friends, because everyone thinks you're having sex with your brother. And it's gross. And I'm saying this because I'm your friend. Well, I'm not, but I'm, like, nice.
High school is terrible.
Mm-hmm. High school is awful.
Can Charlie just, like, catch a break just once? Just
absolutely
catch
not.
Catch a fucking break. My poor baby. Okay, so I, you know, just obviously, well, I think James would be up and off of me at that point.
Oh, he definitely is.
You know, and I'm
James
just,
knows his place.
I'm just laying on the floor just, like... I don't have any friends, and my brother won't be friends with me either. So.
Oh my God, Rugrats All Grown Up had 5 seasons.
What?
It had a lot of seasons to it. I mean, we were all wrong.
You put the small phone away.
Way closer with 3
seasons.
Put
the jitterbug away.
God. So.
It's a lot of Rugrats All Grown
sad.
Up.
I'm just feeling sad and alone right now.
Not gonna do anything about it?
No, what can I do? I mean, I could just like sizzle her phone, which.
You could. You can sizzle her phone. You could pull a carry and make all the lockers freak out on her. There's, you have options.
Yeah, that's true. So I'm going to, I'm definitely gonna sizzle her phone. I'm gonna brick her phone because I have a lot of practice with that.
No, I thought she was the bully. Phone bricker.
Look.
I ain't saying he's a phone bricker.
I want to finish that, but I don't know how. Okay, you brick her phone, and she goes, oh my God.
And then I do the lockers.
And then locker swings over and hits her in the face.
No, it's literally like, so at my high school, we had like short rows of lockers, but it was like, you know, both sides. So what I imagine is like we're kind of in the middle because that was like in the middle of the cafeteria. The small calf had those lockers in them. And so we're like between a set, but I make all the lockers just fly open just to spook her, not to...
Oh, yeah, no, she shrieks and drops her phone.
Okay.
And you get a smug little satisfaction out of that.
Oh, it's great, and I'm still laying on the floor just like...
The school weed dealer like rushes over to his locker.
Whoa, not chill, man.
When, cool. One day when they
locker.
True story. When there was one day when they brought the drug dogs around, one of our friends was terrified that they were gonna like peg his locker because he had like an old Easter bunny, like a chocolate Easter bunny, left in his locker, and they thought the dogs were gonna smell it and thought it was drugs. I went to an all white school.
We had the drug dogs come by a lot.
We did not.
NorCal. Weed Valley.
Oh, okay. Ours was heroin, so, no.
We just did a lot of E and smoked weed. Good Lord.
No, there was a serious heroin problem at one of my local
high
schools.
What the fuck, Iowa?
Illinois. Chicago. Whatever. Suburbs.
Same place.
Not
starts
the same
with an
place.
I. Basically the same.
Started with an I, you fly over it, like, who cares?
We just had the big blue meth epidemic in my high school.
Because I'm from Albuquerque.
Fun fact, apparently the blue meth shows up in Walking Dead.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, that's so hilarious. I think Walter White caused the zombie apocalypse.
Actually, sorry, just fun anecdote, and then we'll get back to the game. There is a candy shop in Albuquerque, New Mexico, called the Candy Lady that when I was a kid, they used to take us on field trips to see them making the candy, and one of their specialties was rock candy. Mm. So when Breaking Bad was in production, what they did is they contracted with the Candy Lady to make all the blue rock candy that stood in for the meth.
Apparently, wow. If you worked on the show, you had to do meth at least once. By eating it.
Oh, yes, sorry. I was like, what? Anyway, sorry, back to the story.
Don't do meth, kids.
Yeah.
All right.
Creator Breaking Bad is from Richmond.
There you go. Yeah.
Jordan just wanted to contribute to that conversation. Yeah.
So, District 8 and District 7. We're actually going to start with 7. Here are some names, and we'll go ahead and take it to a quick vote with the three of you. Okay. Flawseed.
How do you spell that?
You don't have to write it down. I'm just going to list them off. You guys
but
can make.
No, it's very important.
F-L-A-W, seed.
Okay.
Tenebrae.
I like that.
T-E-N-E-B-R-A-E.
I like that.
Brandon.
Just Brandon.
Brandon.
Brandon. The Brandon district.
It's just like some CEO's kid like got to name the district.
Brandon.
I'm naming it Brandon. Give it like a place name. No, it's Brandon.
Ouroboron Corp. I guess it's this is a corporate-owned district.
That eats its own tail?
Mm-hmm.
I guess that's Ouroboros.
Boros.
Ouroboros.
Is that a City of Heroes nod?
Ouroboros.
I hope it is. I hope it is.
I don't know. Continue.
Midway and Wave Meat.
I'm going to say Midway.
Mm. I like Brandon.
Midway or Flawseed?
We've got two to name, right?
Yes.
Seven
See,
and eight.
I like Midway and Tenebrae.
I like Tenebrae too.
I like Tenebrae.
See, I would
Brandon.
Say Midway would be 7 and then Tenebrae would be 8.
I like that.
Okay.
We all in agreement?
Midway is the middle point between the Strip and Questware.
Yep.
And my brain is like airport? Because.
Yeah, I know, exactly. That's what I was
How
thinking.
Do I spell
I like
Tenebrae?
Brandon, chat person.
N E.
T E N E?
Yes.
B R A E?
Yep. All right, thank you, chat.
I just wanted to make sure it was just one N and not two S.
Which I believe is Spanish or Latin for shadow.
Mm.
And the Spanish word for creepy is tenebroso.
Tenebroso.
Ooh.
Literally means shade.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, tenebroso.
See, yeah, Tenebrae is a nicer sounding word. It's a fancy sounding word, so, because it's a wealthy neighborhood.
Mm-hmm. That's where all the vampires live, too.
Yeah.
Blah!
Blah! It's a hell of a commute for Charlie's mom to get from their home to Fetacorp, but.
Oh, yeah, it's a horrible commute, but there's a good train system. Currently shut down, but
oh
good.
Yeah, no, there's probably a train that goes the opposite direction and shares the station with the J train.
Yeah,
it's my guess, but we haven't drawn that in.
No, so it's not canon yet. Also, a quick reminder for all of our viewers: Patreon backers get to own and name a district, and you get to describe what's in it and also what type of mooks you have. I can't remember who we had last week, but last week
Zenar Faith.
Zenar Faith, thank you. Zenar Faith had his cult of white-haired floating bird people. Well, they weren't actually bird people, but they had like a bird motif going on. I think they work out of Questwear. I'm not positive.
Yeah,
we'll
no,
double check with them.
Started in Questwear.
Yeah.
No. They may have worked out of Questwear, but we were at the high school.
You were at the high school.
Yeah.
Which we still have not named.
We have not named it yet.
No.
But I'm going to write school.
Cool.
It's PS118.
School.
All right. Bell rings. You go to class. Uneventful. Mm-hmm. Class wraps up. And so the three of you meet at the workshop. Mm-hmm. It's a little eerie because Golden Arm's not there.
I like it when he's not here. It's so quiet.
He's in the hospital, dude.
You know. I'm sad about that, but I do also appreciate being
in
the shop.
You can feel both things.
Yeah, come on.
Well,
come on.
That's
you can
fair.
Feel multiple emotions at
and
one
you
time.
Were about to appreciate the serenity and just how, you know, this is history. And then Jonas walks by eating Fruity Pebbles in his boxers.
Would you
Stop.
Please? You don't live here. You're just being
I live
kept
here.
Here.
Oh, no, I live here.
You don't live here.
Oh, you want to bet? Check the sink.
What is happening?
I had to do my laundry somewhere.
Oh, okay. There was a couple of ways that could have gone.
That is not Steven. Steven.
So, remind me again why we're keeping this person prisoner in our
I can answer that. God. Generic Fruity Pebbles just don't taste the same.
Shut.
Not even up. Just shut.
I agree.
Well, I know everyone involved with getting the Emerald Inferno, Green Inferno.
I've heard both used. I think they're both okay.
They need to pick
Emerald
one.
Emerald Inferno just seems like they're trying to be showy on both
yeah.
ends.
Yeah, but it's, okay.
It's like the...
Hey.
It's easy
no.
to remember that way.
Stop with the semantics. So the thing is that he is, you know, he knows, you know, everybody that's involved with it. We have the list. But he's also...
And if you turn me into Devereaux, he's going to kill me.
Yeah, so we're keeping him safe, and he's upset about this for some stupid reason.
Oh, no, I'm not upset about it. I've been thinking about it. It's actually a really good deal. See, you need an adult. You need an adult. I qualify.
No, you do not qualify.
I qualify.
In what world
You're
do you qualify?
Qualify as an adult as much as Billy Bob Thornton and Bad Santa. Forgive me for saying. Also, look at you.
I'm in good shape. What are you on about?
Wait, he's Kevin's new dad, right?
He puts a cereal down. That is not how that.
Go.
Theo, can I talk to you for a second?
Sure.
Cool. Does Gregor know that he's here?
Gregor doesn't. I have not fed Gregor any information.
You guys do know when you're in the workshop, your communicators don't. Nothing really works down here because it's pretty deep.
Yeah.
I would say
it's basically a panic room.
Sure.
I would say it's fair to assume there's a good chance he knows he's here. Because if there's anything we've found out, it's that Gregor knows a lot about most things and that most technology is compromised in some sense.
Okay. Well, we've got to keep an eye out for him, too, because he may be really useful into us getting to the Emerald Inferno without Gregor's help.
I agree.
And then you look over and he's...
Put some clothes on.
What clothes? I had one pair.
Put your clothes on.
They're wet in the sink.
I will get you some clothes.
Thank you.
What happened to cybernetic arms?
They're just kind of not here. He left them because the original plan was come here, turn it in, and leave. But then Ash and Ember were here, so kind of got involved. There's some legality issues.
They're so awesome.
They are awesome.
Well, Ember is. Amber's a bitch. Ash is a bitch.
Ash is Grace Ember's Jones. Great. She's awesome.
Yeah.
It's my Grace Ember, Jones face.
Ember is like Jessica Williams.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. She's great.
Not Wendy Williams.
All right, six shooter.
No, not Wendy Williams.
Tell us what you know. I'm just, I hate to put too fine a point on it, but you have to understand that the Emerald Inferno is uncomfortably close to home for us because Swole here just recently became infected with it. Temporarily. But we can't have that happen again.
Oh, dude, buddy, nice.
Hey!
Oh!
Oh, sorry.
Bad life decisions. I continue to make them.
My muscle density is pretty thick.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh my god, I once got into a fight with a brick wall, it didn't hurt this much.
Me too.
Oh, you met him?
The brick wall?
Yeah.
I mean, I just got into a fight with a brick wall.
Fair enough.
Not the brick wall.
No. It was a yogurt lad. They don't let us back anymore.
The Olive Garden loves you, though.
They don't let us back anymore.
They're right across the parking lot from each other, too, you know? I mean...
It's just awkward. It's like seeing your ex in public. So, well,
where do we go? I mean, give us a starting direction at least, because
well, first off, don't forget about your buddy here, because I had that green shit in my brain too.
Really?
Does it linger? I mean,
no, dude. It's like having a. Let's see. I need to find a PG way of asking this.
Oh, we fucking cursed. Don't worry.
You're cute. Have you guys ever had too much soda pop? Put it that way. That's right. Kids drink that, right? Good.
Are you asking where we've been drunk? I mean, we're high schoolers.
Okay, have you smoked meth? There, are you happy?
Oh, no. Oh. No, that's gross.
No, yeah.
I'm shaming you.
I did it once in college. Get off my ass.
So you're saying that there's some sort of come down to it, but there's a high associated with it?
You kind of go somewhere else for a while, and when I came back, I had done some damage.
Yeah, I could back that one.
I apologize for that. And I didn't remember it. But, like, it hasn't come back since. It's been, like, over a month.
Well,
sober as a nun.
That's good to know. I'd hate to think that my brain could just flip into that mode at any time.
All right.
That
so
would
where
be
do we
frustrating.
Start?
I don't know where you start. I wasn't responsible for keeping it. I was just responsible for getting it out of where it was.
And where was it?
There was a crash site, somewhere in the desert.
I don't...
Let's go there!
Do well in heat. I just want to say that right now.
You don't do well in the heat?
Yeah, not really fun. And not like powers-wise, I don't like it.
Ow.
Yeah.
Actually, I just realized we're on the East Coast here, so,
The plains?
The plains, there we go.
Somewhere out here.
Yeah. I don't know, somewhere with, there's a shit ton of corn.
Iowa?
Or Illinois, same thing.
No, Illinois is soybeans, Iowa is corn.
No, they're basically the same.
And Idaho's potatoes.
They're all the eyes.
And Ohio is tired.
And we all move away from them when we turn 18 and get kicked out of the house, either way.
Done.
I lived with my parents' lifestyle too.
Hmm.
Yeah, well.
I'd hug you, but I'm still in my underwear.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a crash site. Me and the other expendables, that's what I was calling us. They didn't like it, but I'm a fan of it. We're sent out there, we got it, took it to Devereaux. A couple months later, kaboom.
Who else was involved? I mean, I know one of us has the list, so you don't have to go over it again.
Yes. I gave you guys
the
list.
I have,
you did, yeah.
Do I have the list?
But I was passed out at that point.
I have the list. Yeah.
Because that was, I believe, post-fight with Queen
Mitch. As an update, the list contains Six Shooter, so this asshole.
Hi.
Skeleton Key, who can open any doors.
She can create and open doors, yes.
Okay. Anvil, who has similar powers to Swole.
Yeah.
Red Dragon, who
you don't know much about.
We don't know much about. And Mr. Mercury, who I'm guessing is just a female version or a male version of Sailor Mercury.
That was where the expression came from.
See, I'm picturing like Freddie Mercury.
Looks like Freddie Mercury.
Yeah. Yes, he does.
Looks like the Flash Gordon shirt.
But it has the powers of Sailor Mercury.
Well, if I wasn't
with the bubbles.
Before.
What was that?
If I wasn't gay before.
Yeah, right.
With the bubbles. Yeah. He has bubble powers.
Born to be king.
We're the princes of the universe.
Here we are. Fighting for survival.
Yeah.
We've tried for a lot before.
Saying our karaoke needs to happen already.